In the previous lecture, we have gone through multidimensional arrays, and in this lecture, we will be solving a problem related to it. So the problem is Roy and Asymmetric Logos, and the problem is taken from HackerEarth. The problem statement is, Roy likes symmetric logos. How to check whether a logo is symmetric? Align the center of logo with the origin of Cartesian plane. Now, if the colored pixel of the logo are symmetric about both x-axis and y-axis, then the logo is symmetric. And you are given a binary matrix of size n cross n, which represent the pixel of a logo. 1 indicates that the pixel is colored and 0 indicates that no color. Okay, so we are given a matrix of 0 and 1. In which one says that the pixel is colored and zero says that pixel is not colored, like here in this example. And we are having two axes, x axis and y axis, and the logo is symmetric if it is symmetric to x axis and it is symmetric to y axis, like this one. This is symmetric to y axis, and this way it is symmetric to x axis. And when these both conditions are fulfilled, then the logo is symmetric, right? So how we can solve this problem? Okay, so to solve this, let us go through another example, and let's go through the observation which is useful here to solve this problem. So let us say that we are given a matrix 4 cross 4, which is like this: 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 0 1, right? And 1 is colored, which is here in reddish color, right? And draw the y axis and x axis, right? And after this, what we need to check? We need to check whether the logo is symmetric to y axis. So if it is symmetric to y axis, then each of the row should be a palindrome. Right, like here 1 is matching to 1, 0 is matching to 0, 0 is matching to 0, 1 is matching to 1. Here also 0 matches 0, 1 matches 1, and here 1 matches 1 and 0 matches 0. Right, so if all the rows are palindrome, then it is symmetric to y-axis. Right, and if the same condition followed for the x-axis, like all the columns are palindrome, like 1 and 1 matches, 0, 0 matches. Here also 0 matches to 0, 1 matches to 1. Here also 0 matches 0, 1 matches 1, 1 matches 1 and 0 matches 0. So this is palindrome to y-axis also and x-axis also, right? Like each of the row are palindrome to x-axis and each of the column are also palindrome, which represent that it is symmetric to x-axis, right? So this is a symmetric logo. Now let's take another matrix like this. And here if we see, this matrix is not symmetric, right? Like this row is not symmetric to the y-axis because this row is not a palindrome. Similarly for this row, so this is not a symmetric matrix. So the observation here is, if all the rows and all columns are palindrome, then the logo is symmetric, else not. So what we need to check? We need to check that all the rows are palindrome and all the columns are palindrome, right? So this is how we will be solving this problem. And now let us go through the code for this problem. Okay, so let's write the code for this problem. And in the input, we are given t test cases and n to be the size of matrix n cross n. And n can go up to 32. Okay, and we will get a binary string. Okay, so we will make an string array. And string is an array of characters, right? So we can iterate string like we iterate in an array. So int t, now what we need to do, while t minus minus, right? So we have taken n as an input. Now we need to make an array which is of type string t of n, right? After this, what we need to do, we need to take all the element as an input. Okay, so now we have taken all the elements as an input. Now we need to make two variables which will be flag for row and column. Row flag equal to true and call flag to true. That is, initially we assume that all row and all column are palindrome, and after this we will check through. First we will check through row and then we will check for the column. Now what we need to do, we need to check whether test of array of I, which is row, and j is not equal to a of I n minus j minus 1, right? Like here, if this and this doesn't match, then it will not be a palindrome, right? So what we will do, flag equal to false and break, right? After which, if not a flag, then row flag equal to false and break, right? And we will do the same thing for column also. And in column, what we need to do, we need to make this as a j and this to be I. And we are done, right? And now what we can do, we will check whether row f and call f both are true or not. If row f and call f, that is, both are true, then print yes, else puts no. Right, and all are capital letters. Yes, all are capital letters. Right, so we are done with the code. So now we can compile it. So we are done with the code and it has compiled successfully and sample test case passed. So we can submit our code now. Okay, so we have finished the solution, and the simple observation in this problem was that each row should be a palindrome and each column should be a palindrome for the logo to be symmetric, right? So with this, we finish the solution for this problem. In the next, we will look into dynamic arrays and we will study about vectors in C++.